Fuck that. Put the boogie in your butt, in the butt, in your boogie, in the boogie, in your butt, in your butt, in the boogie. Shake it on down, shake it on down, going down now. It's Christmas time, final. It's 420, bro. Look at us. It's the day when all the brothers and sisters of the Kind Bud community get together to, you know, puff one and get ripped at 420 on 420 in the 420s. You know, bro?
Yeah, everybody at once.
Everybody
around the world,
across the world, is all 420.
All at the same time.
We're all 420.
Too bad there's different time zones,
which makes it impossible for everyone to actually do this all at once unless they stagger their times. And some will be up in the middle of the night, and others will be in the middle of the afternoon smoking at the same time. In unity, unison, everyone achieving the vibe, the vibrations.
You have to puff it for 24 hours straight just to make sure you're doing it at the same time.
Yep. So that it overlaps in a Venn diagram of getting baked everywhere all the time. Bro.
Yeah, just smoke it every day and then you won't have to worry about it.
Yeah, you'll forget to, you know, you'll start to forget to bathe and you won't care because you won't be able to smell yourself. Everybody will be slathered in patchouli, dead body.
Well, I recall, there was never a specific time that you, that's like saying, you know, you shouldn't drink until, you know, at least afternoon.
That's a good, you know, pretty, that's pretty solid though.
No, it's not.
That's what I meant. How dare they try to put expectations on that?
There's no right or wrong time for anything.
Listen, there are only rights and wrongs times. That's how life is governed.
Well, I saw a thing down here in Tennessee, and it was like you couldn't buy alcohol on Easter Day. It's like a state law.
But you could buy it on Easter night. Hello.
Yeah. You show up afternoon. Hey, come on, man. It's almost night.
Pretending to be all fucking righteous and shit.
Yeah.
Because it's the Lord's Day, I'm going to wait until after 4:30 to get wasted.
Well, I think they just want people to show up to church.
Yeah, so they can pump their money in there and in other systems of disbelief.
Yeah.
You need to give your money to the Lord.
All the ministers were probably complaining. They're like, yeah, they're out there blowing all their money on alcohol. We need some money to keep our churches open.
He's like, yeah, I need money to buy another big, crazy, huge watch and shit.
Yeah. You should see some of these churches down here. They're pretty big. There's a lot of them. Lots.
The faith is strong.
Oh, yeah.
The money is abundant. That means God loves us more. Don't you get it? Oh, shit.
So back to the 420 thing.
Yo, bro. What about...
Where did this originate? Because, you know, I never heard it until I was almost done puffing.
Or at least done fucking living the fucking 24/7 bake cycle.
Yeah, the 20... It's 24/20. It's
427.
Yeah.
Bro. Yeah.
420.
We're like
24/7.
Like if your eyes were open, it seemed like it was a go. Whatever.
It's like the first thing you look for.
Yep. reach
the first thing you look for and the last thing you look for, yep. And everything
you wake
you
up
look for in between
is all just vanity, bro. The rest is just getting baked. Yeah,
entire days and weeks and months just consumed,
floating by in a river of meaninglessness. Fucking
yep, just looking for it.
Smoking the next,
wondering where the next bowl will be.
A life of quiet desperation. Searching for the next bowl.
I gotta learn how to do that with money. Just quit fucking wondering where the next dollar is gonna come from. And then it will just flow.
I wish you luck with that. That's a journey. I like it.
A journey to homelessness.
Yeah. A short journey to the curb. You're like, well, you know, the curb's not too far away, so it looks comfy.
Yeah. It's like a pillow. You can rest your head on it.
I'm a curb guy. I really like curbs. Just resting his fucking bucket head on a curb and shit. This is great.
Yep. It wasn't until he rested on a curb that he realized that, you know, the concrete pillow was the way to go.
Yeah, it's like, here's what I'm... Everything's going towards the concrete pillow. Yeah, oh. President Trump said he likes it.
I actually just threw my pillow away.
Did you?
Yeah, because I washed it. And then I, like...
Fucked it all up.
Put it in the dryer, and then... It didn't dry all the way, and then I went and took a whiff of it. And it fucking smelled like a shirt that's... Got that stench in it, you know, you can't get rid of. Like a sweaty shirt, old shirt.
That's because you fucking violated that pillow so many times, man.
I know.
Fucking thing didn't owe you a dime.
So then it was like, well, I was like, I'm going to use some bleach this time. And I washed it again with some bleach. And then I dried it. And I pulled it out and it still smelled like a wet, hot t-shirt in the summertime, all sweaty.
How old is the
pillow? I was like, fuck this thing, man. This is going.
How old was the pillow?
So I tossed that out, and then I just went and I slept on the curb.
Yeah, it was a lot better.
Yeah.
It smelled like dog piss.
No big deal.
Fucking, how old was the pillow, man? Fucking lazy sack of shit. Gross.
It's been a lot of sweaty nights.
Was it one you had?
My neck tends to sweat sometimes.
Was it one you had in Florida or something, or what?
I don't know, man.
Fucking gross, dude.
But I got rid of that fucker. I was like, if I wash this thing and it fucking stinks, fuck that. Twice.
Yeah. It's like, what are you making, poke salad and shit? What the fuck?
Well, I think I let it stay damp a little too long, but still, you know, it just had that funk about it. It's like, fuck this.
Yeah. Bunch of fucking mouth shit all over it. And
oh, yeah, man. Sweat. Just drooling and sweating and fucking
and all those times you plugged its fucking backside and shit and fucking cream pie. You
think of it, what's a pillow? Like $50, you know, for a decent pillow.
Yeah. Why skimp, man? You should change those like you
do. Yeah, right? You put your head on that thing like fucking 6 to 8 hours a fucking day.
Gross. Just slobbering on it and breathing all over it.
Yeah, it's probably dirtier in the toilet.
And there you are, putting your fucking face on it all night.
Yep, night after night after night.
It's like letting a dog lick your mouth.
Yep, for years and years. Just like, oh, my pillow. Grab it and shove it right under your head.
Right in between your legs and then just violate that son of a bitch.
Yep. There's a hole in the stuffing.
There's a hole in the stuffing. Dear Eliza, a hole.
You're like, oh, I forgot about that. Oh, well.
Oh, yeah, that's right. I used to really jack this thing up. I think I got it pregnant twice.
It's got a petroleum fucking waxed hole on it.
Oh, Christ. A petroleum wax hole. polished like the Blarney Stone and shit.
Yeah.
Fucking gross.
Too many 420 nights.
Yeah, that's what happens, man.
And you forget.
What's up with this fucking tune? Did you want to discuss the origins of 420, bro?
Well, sure, man.
All right, let's see.
Even though I don't give a fuck about 420, never have, never will.
You want to know? I can tell by your voice. There it is, top search. According to Time Magazine, 420 can be traced to 1971, when a group of five students at San Rafael High School in Marin County, California, began meeting at 4:20 p.m. to smoke marijuana. 1971, before I even was born.
Fuck that California shit.
In the 1970s, when a group of teenagers from San Rafael High School in Marin County, or Marin County, maybe, I don't know, I'm not from California, would ritualistically smoke marijuana at 4:20 each day. The number 4:20 became their code for marijuana. The five students called themselves the Waldos, which referenced the wall they would sit on at their school.
Waldo?
Yeah, the Waldos.
The Dildos?
The Dildos. Oh shit, everybody party. Sugar Magnolia, blossoms blooming, heads all empty and I don't care. Saw my baby down by the river, knew she'd have to come up soon for air. Sweet blossom come on under the willow. We can have high times if you'll abide. We can discover the wonders of nature, growing in the rushes down by the riverside. She's got everything delightful. She's got everything I need. Takes the wheel when I see a double. Pays my ticket when I speed. Aw, oh, shit. Solo time.
That was like the gayest guitar sound ever.
What's that?
It's like the gayest guitar sound ever.
Which one?
The one in that song.
Well, there's like three fucking guitar tones going on, buddy.
Well, the one with like the phaser and the wah pedal on it or whatever.
Oh, with the overdrive on it, the slide shit? Mm-hmm. 420 is a slang term or a kind of code word referring to marijuana or marijuana use. Due to this association, 420 is also used as the name of an unofficial holiday that marijuana enthusiasts celebrate by using marijuana. It is sometimes called Weed Day. Weed is a slang term for marijuana.
Weed Day.
What is 420 police code? Some say 420 is code among police officers for marijuana smoking in progress. Some note 420 is also Adolf Hitler's birthday. And some go as far as to cite Bob Dylan's song Rainy Day Number Women Number 12 and 35 because 12 multiplied by 35 equals 420.
Oh no.
How fucking gay can you be?
being a little bitch. Blooming like a red rose. Even though it did do.
Deep row, deep noise, 12 times 35 equals.
Is it 420, bro?
Yeah, man, let's do it.
It's time, man, like the Waldos.
Yeah, like Bob Dylan.
Like Bob Dylan and the Dildos. His backing.
I'm just chilling, like Bob Dylan. Yeah, I smoke Sheba. It helps him with my brain. Might be a little dusty, but I'm not insane.
Bob Dylan's backing band is are the Dildos.
Yeah.
Listen, man. Fuck this fucking Grateful Dead, goddammit. People all went insane. Don't make me fucking... Don't make me play the live version of One More Saturday Night on your ass.
Please, no.
What's this?
Please don't do it.
Broke Down Palace? What's this all about? What's this bullshit? Do this anymore.
Yeah, you're just gonna waste our time. Keep trying to find a good one.
a lifetime spent wondering where it was.
There's better music out there, man. Come on.
I know. Are you ready for some?
Yeah. Forget this 420. I mean, if you're gonna play stoner music, it's gotta at least be Bob Marley or Pink Floyd.
Hold on. Here's one. It's called Chuayaku. Don't fuck with me. For 20 is a day, like any other day. But it's got the special magic, because all of my brothers and sisters all around the country, and even the planet, are smoking with me right now. In their idiocy and lunacy, lost in a spiraling circle of patchouli and filth. But it's not all filth, good brother and sport sister. There's magic in it. Don't you see the magic? Can't you feel it? Can't you see it? Why don't you want to try and be it? I feel the magic in this joint, in that bowl, in that cracker of that shit that makes you go, wow, 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 wow. There's some stoner, there's some trippy music. Stonery.
Yeah, it's like Andean flute music or something.
You're dead on. That's exactly what the hell that is. Andean flute music.
Well, it sounds like it.
Here's a song for you. Did you like that little burst?
Yeah, I like the oldies, man.
Yeah.
Oldies are the oldies but goodies, you know?
Oh, dude. Doodles, doodly doodles. Yeah, fuck yeah, here. I have a little playlist that I called I call it soda shop. Or malt shop. Malt shop. There we go. Yeah, yeah.
Bam!
How about like this? Little Frankie Valli. Or check this. It's like we're back working at Orlando's and shit.
Love is a many splendid thing. It's the April rose that only grows in the early spring. Love is nature's way of giving a reason to be living, the golden crown that makes a man a king.
Brother, or how about this fucking classic? Do you remember
the
this?
Temps, the Temps and the Aces.
Yeah. Listen, folks, it's important to remember that once upon a time, people smoked indoors and shit, and fucking said all kinds of fucked up shit, but they didn't bitch out as much. What's this devolution about? Why don't we take a trip back to this time and day and have a fucking highball and a smoke and tell somebody to fuck off?
Hey, fuck me. Pass me the penis.
Yo, fuckhead.
Give me another beer, Dad. Knucklehead.
Knucklehead. Cha cha cha, cha cha cha, cha cha cha, cha cha cha, cha cha cha.
Hey, why don't you take you and the Bambino go at the flick, eh, baby?
Hey, you got two choices. You're going out the door or you're going out the window. You choose. Tough gay. That's fucking hilarious. And then on the totally fakey veneer of the 50s, you have shit like this. Yes. The wings were too icy. That'd be the day that I die. Here's a great song. This is one of my favorites. That was a good tune. Is this the one I think it is?
Do you have Mr. Sandman by Chet Atkins?
Mr. Sandman? Let me see.
Yeah. The Chet Atkins version.
You right now. Oh, folks, you're in for a treat. God damn, if you've never listened to this man.
Thank you.
check it.
Yo.
This is Chet Atkins and Les Paul. Get a little sleepy. Here is a tune called Country Gentleman, which became Chet Atkins' kind of like namesake. His model of guitar was the Gretsch Country Gentleman.
Very interesting.
The value of the Chet Atkins Gretsch model.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm fucking telling you, like used, some of the used ones, the older ones, 14,500, 57 and 56 for $24,950.
How many were made?
Orange 57 for 10,200. I don't know, dude. 60 years ago this summer, my uncle Fred Gretsch Jr. and a rising Nashville session and recording guitar star named Chet Atkins put their signatures on. Let me see this. Put their signature on a simple 2-page contract. Neither of them could have predicted what was about to happen, or that this long and fruitful relationship would endure 60 years later. So what made it work? I think it was a textbook example of what can happen when the right people and the right company come together at just the right time. Ay, ay, ay. Crazy style, man.
And being a good guitar player?
What's that?
I said, and being a good guitar player?
Oh, yeah, I imagine that figured in somewhere. Somewhere in there.
Somewhere. Some autograph.
Yeah, something about doing shit like this.
It'd have to be a fool not to get a signature cadaver like that.
And he's not even fucking letting it rip here.
Oh no, he's just picking and clinking.
Yeah, he's just having fucking fun. I'm fucking sorely disappointed, though, I do not have Arkansas Traveler in my iPod at this time. Can't believe
that. Oh, snap.
Can't believe that shit. Fuck.
Yeah, it's a good jam.
Oh, dude. It's a fucking sterling example of some fucking crazy shit. That dude's fucking fingers are going faster than his brain and shit.
Well, I could always send it to you.
Yeah, well, I've got YouTube, you fucking peckerwood. Hang on.
We'll start it at the same time.
Yeah.
So that I can pretend I'm listening to it.
Uh-huh.
Oh, these are a bunch of ones that aren't him.
You know who's kind of in that wheelhouse, but would bring us up to the 80s? Would be Brian Setzer, Stray Cats and shit. Like that, he's like here's some Rock This Town, but in the Brian Setzer Orchestra version. That's much different than the version I've come to know.
There's a race called the Arkansas Traveler.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
I see.
It's like 100. The Arkansas Traveler 100.
Making,
100 miles, man.
You're making it up.
That's a fucking... That's a hell of a run right there.
Yeah?
Imagine running 100 miles.
Fuck.
Yeah, fuck that.
That's a long way to fucking...
Yeah, you'd have to, like... practice for, like, a year.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I guess you could do it. You just would have to take breaks.
At least.
Run a mile, take a break.
You know what's an interesting tune?
Huh?
It's this one. Surely you recognize this. Recognize that?
Yeah.
Fucking Lilith Fair.
Fucking save the animals, man.
Yeah. Teary-eyed fucking puppies sitting in puddles.
Yep. Send your money now. They're like, here's $10 million for you. Just pretend like you care. No,
care.
She didn't take any money. I know.
I don't believe that shit at all. She got fucking paid. She got fucking paid. In puppies!
Arms of the angels, man.
Fucking
someone's trying to give us another cat.
Why?
Because they have kittens. It's like, man,
why does it have to be your problem?
Right?
Ugh, fuck all that shit.
Like, so cute, look at them.
I'll manipulate you with its fucking cuteness. Yay.
Yeah.
This is what they need, is more of this. and just know that everything is as it should be in this moment in time, specifically. And never forget that this too shall pass.
Never forget, never forgive.
Never forget, never again. Never forgive. All your heartbreaks will cease.
That doesn't sound very Christian.
All of your misery will end. All of your grievances and grudges.
Hold on to your anger forever.
Hold on to your anger, and it will guide you into the next realm, right where you need to be. As you crawl out into the butthole of some ungodly creature somewhere, and you realize you've been reincarnated as a turd. The ultimate expression of life on this earth. A turd. Listen, you. Quitali.
What happened to Arkansas Traveler? First?
Where the fuck did it go?
Arkansas. Wait, it's an old one.
You're an old one.
There's some picture.
Oh, I just wanted to let you know, because I know you're a big fan and you kind of follow this shit. But, just in case you were wondering, Jada Pinkett Smith, you know, she and her daughter and her mother are back to their Red Table Talk show. Okay? I know you were wondering about that. So they're picking it back up again. They're making big strides in progress in their world.
Wow.
To be
on the, I've ever seen it.
To be on the right side of themselves.
Yeah, like I said, I don't think I've seen it. Is it good?
Oh, man. Riveting.
What channel is it going
to
be on?
You won't be able to stop watching it. I don't know.
Well, you let me know as soon as you find out.
Alright, maybe it's on Facebook or some fucking gayness.
It's on Buckface?
Yeah, Buttface.
Bookbinding? On Fascist Book?
Fascist Book? Ha ha ha. I like it. Alright, I'm gonna
bind them together and then destroy them all.
Alright, check it. I'm gonna play some of this Traveler, man. What's up?
Let's hear it.
Alright. Thank you. Dude, that fucking ripped.
Okay. I just came across this song. I sent it to you. Yeah. It's the history of the Arkansas Treasure. I guess it's an old fiddle song from the 1800s.
Just an old fiddle song. Yeah. Put on my eyeballs for this shit. This 1870 Currier and Ives lithograph was inspired by the Arkansas Traveler, a melody with a story that appeared around 1850 when the tune came into vogue among fiddlers. Arkansas artist Edward Payson Washburn painted this famous scene in 1856. The image depicts a wisecracking, fiddle-playing squatter's encounter with a sophisticated city slicker or traveler. The dialogue and tune, performed and recorded by Steve Potter and Ernest Hare in 1922, are part of the American Variety stage collection at the Library of Congress. Between 1901 and 1919, Len Spencer recorded this song for a variety of record companies such as Edison and Columbia. In 1925, the Blue Ridge Duo recorded a square dance version for the Edison Record Company.
Sounds fun.
So many details. Well, does it?
To the I will send you a picture of that for your thumbnail. Hold on.
But there's one here. I see it. A thumbnail in your ass. Though it is somewhat funny, actually. What a weird picture I'm looking at here. It's this painting that the guy did. It's a little cabin and it says whiskey above the door. And then it looks like either like spoons or ladle or pieces of meat or something hanging off the tree branches. It's pretty wild. Then the squatter.
Yeah, there's one hanging by the door too.
Yeah, what's up with that? That looks like a ladle or a scoop of some kind. Or maybe it's a horn of gunpowder. Oh, nope, that's on his gun. Yeah, it looks like a scoop or a ladle or something. Strange, really. Quite. Whiskey. He's pointing at the sign that says
the whiskey. One looks, it looks like three sixes, man.
Yes. Four sixes. It's even worse. It has come to 24. Why?
Don't forget the one by the door.
Oh. 30? An even 30? A round number? Made of five sixes?
Yep. And then multiply it by two, and what do you get? Six?
66.
That's just evil. Evil whiskey drinkers. Listen to the Arkansas Traveler.
Evil mathematics doers.
Yep. look at the baby on all fours. It's like coming out like a little
creature. I want whiskey. Where's my booze?
And then the one kid looks like a midget. Looks like he has a little beard.
It's a little Satan beard.
Yeah, he's like leaning against the door. You see it?
Yeah. It's fucking nutty shit. I'm going to trim this down right now for the thumbnail.
There's a coonskin hanging on the wall.
Yo, ain't nobody got time for that. Next you'll be telling me there's some fucking soul food in there somewhere. Come on, man.
I bet you they were eating it.
They're like fucking fried okra and black eyed peas and hog jaws and shit. It's all good.
Oh my god, the woman's smoking a pipe and she's got a knife in one hand. and a frying pan in the other.
She's like, I'm going to kill you.
Do you see that knife in her hand?
Is that really a knife or is that another fucking scoop? It looks like a scoop. It's like the scoop hanging by the fucking door. It's like a goddamn whiskey soup kitchen. That little baby on all fours look like it's about to drink out of that fucked up bowl on the fucking ground and shit. Like, I've been drinking whiskey. See the cross-eyed look on its face?
Yeah.
Like, I'm insane. Dude's just coon-skinning it up, fucking playing the fiddle. They weren't fiddling.
That's hilarious.
I wonder if they fiddled it like fucking Chet Atkins was tickling it, though, man. It was fucking out of control. I mean, fuck. The one I played was a live performance on some, like, old fucking... old goddamn... I don't even know what kind of fucking TV show you'd call it. Some sort of fucking variety hour country fucking music fest show. It's fucking out of control, man. What is this Brighteon?
So what other good music you get? Any oldies?
Fuck yeah, man. A sea of oldies swimming in them.
Or should we play newer music?
Well, I was trying to bring us up into the 80s a bit. See what we could think about.
Cool.
You know, what kind of shit do you remember from the 80s?
Oh. Lots of stuff.
Lots of stuff.
Yeah, don't forget Careless Whisper. I mean, come on.
Who could forget Careless Whispers? Who could ever forget?
I was over at Sergi Beats' house one night.
Uh-huh.
And his old lady busted out Wham. She was singing along to everything. It was hilarious.
Laughing my ass off. Again. Wasted feelings got no rhythm. That's easy to pretend. I know you're not a fool. Let's see if I got it. Careless Love, Careless Blues. No Careless Whispers, really? Oh, wow. It seems like I'm not careless with my whispers here, man.
Can you Pet Shop Boys?
Good question. Damn, this is going to really probably stretch it because I don't know that I went too nuts with the 80s of it all. I think so. Yeah, Pet Shop Boys. There we go. Hey, man, I've got the 2-disc set. Pop Art, baby.
West End Girls?
You mean like this? Oh, snap. Oh, these fucking intros. Get to it, motherfucker. Remember this Pet Shop Boys tune?
Yeah. With Gracie Slick.
What's that?
I said with Gracie Slick.
Was she in it?
Yeah, that's her voice. Listen.
Throw me out some names, man. What do you remember as electronic from the 80s?
Oh, there was a band called Electronic.
Yeah, well, I don't know what the hell that gay shit is, but I do not have. I have something like...
Well, you should love it, man. It's a super group formed by singer and guitarist Bernard Sumner of New Order and guitarist Johnny Marr of the Smiths.
Hmm.
They co-wrote the majority of their output between 1989 and
1998. Oh, so they're gay.
This is collaborating with Neil Tennant and Chris Lowe of Pet Shop Boys.
Electronic shit. Who is it? Here's some New Order for you.
No problem in mind, but it's a problem.
Aaron Eno?
He's gonna get down on his knees.
And pray.
Like a wet seal.
Yeah. Arr. I'm floating in the deep blue day.
Who?
Deep blue day.
It is.
It's a deep blue day, boy.
It's 429.
429?
Yep. It's 429, bro. We started smoking 9 minutes ago, now we're high.
9 days ago, brother.
Oh, 9 days. I forgot my name.
And it doesn't matter anymore, because we're here now.
Hey man, you know, I just started smoking this green stuff. And you know what? It's pretty good. I think it's okay.
Does it make you feel funny?
Oh, it makes me feel good.
Then why doesn't everybody smoke it all at the same time all over the world?
This sounds like a great idea. I got a name. We should start a podcast. We should call it Sorry, I'm Stupid. I just figured out that this stuff is really good. Well, now that it's legal, it's okay.
And, well, you know what they say, better late than never.
Choo-choo-choo.
So now that we found it, we have to make up for lost time and smoke 10 times as much as we would have otherwise.
That sounds like a great idea.
Then every time we do something truly dumb, we can say, Sorry, I'm stupid. And giggle like a fucking idiot. And they'll just...
Well, I just figured out that I got a button on my pants.
It's the one that lets the poops out.
It's a hatch door on my overalls.
It's a little shit flapper.
It's like, man, because you know, if you got to unstrip them overalls and all, that's a lot of work. You need one of them back flaps.
Back
the button.
The back flap. Fucking disgusting, man. That's gross. Back flap. Back flap.
I went down to the country living store and picked me up a pair.
Yeah, the more I think about it, the more fucking unnerving that the more unnerving that shit is. Gross, dude. It's a rape flap.
The back strap flap.
Oh, fuck. That is fucked up. The flap in your back strap. Fucking gross.
You just lift it up. Yeah. It's just flapping over.
Oh, yeah.
Over the crack. It's covering the crack.
Fucking gross.
You gotta lift it every time or you shit all over.
Oh. You make a big mess of yourself.
The backstrap flap.
Just go on and
it's a rare condition, but it can happen.
Yeah, just stick it in there, it's okay. anywhere in there is alright. Fucking gross.
Oh, fuck. Sorry, I'm stupid.
Well, I just put on some some Golden Pond sounds so we can act like we're just splashing around in a couple
tunes. Is there a nice fan of Golden Pond?
Oh. Drink enough beer, they're all Golden Ponds.
Learning the lessons of fishing.
And crawdads.
And noodling.
Noodling and frogging and shit, gigging for frogs.
Yeah, getting them crawdaddies in your net. Mm-hmm.
That reminds me, man, I got some fucking shrimp in the freezer. I gotta eat it up.
Sounds tasty.
Some big fatties.
Hey, you know what I read earlier?
Huh.
That half of the world's seafood production is done in aquafarms these days.
Yeah, they see a lot of fucking shit. Is it
that, farm raising that shit?
Is it that, or is it that that's what goes to the market?
Yeah, well, I'm sure it's a lot more work going out and just harvesting in the ocean because they fished a lot of areas out.
Well, yeah, plus if you have a farm, you can go and scoop them all up, no problem. You got it all engineered to scoop them up.
Oh, yeah, I was watching this thing on crayfish down in, Louisiana. And, it was just choke-loaded. They plant, rice, and then they put them in there to breed, the little krill fuckers, and then they get bigger.
Oh.
They'd scoop them out and shit. And then they had rice grown at the same time. It was crazy. Millions of them.
A twofer.
Yep. I was like, now they something. Then they made some gumbo.
They said it's like GMO gumbo.
Yeah.
Gumbo. Gumbo.
Yeah, they use golden green rice.
Ooh.
Do you remember that commercial, the golden green rice?
No. Was that Hawaii?
No, it was probably back in the 90s, maybe early 2000s.
Golden green rice?
Well, they used to have this commercial, and it was talking about bioengineering. And they had this golden rice, and they were going to use it. It was probably one of those seeds that fucking McGapes came up with, right?
Yeah, it's to help people break down over years genetically so that they can become soy.
Yeah, they put beta carotene into this rice, so it was orange, right?
Uh huh.
And they named it golden rice or something like that. And they're saying how it was going to feed people in third world countries and help them with their vision because, they suffer from, poor nutrition and they have eyesight loss, and this was the magic grain that was going to heal the planet.
But then
they never actually produced any. It was just a commercial to make them look good, to get people to invest.
Yes, the rice of death. I remember it fondly. My childhood. Oh, nothing but rice of death.
Yes, we ate the orange rice and everybody becomes sick and die in our village.
Everyone went sterile and wanted to jump on the comet to join the heavens whole. Die in some weird, violent way.
Christ. Oh, yeah. I guess they did, didn't they? I heard something about that.
Fuck, man.
They're so distressed they fucking committed suicide.
Yeah, what? Fuck.
They realize they've been had.
Phenobarbital and fucking cyanide and shit and put a bag over your head. Chase it with vodka and then put a goddamn bag over your head.
Yep, while playing your favorite music.
We are the robots. Boop, 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 boop. I feel all hot and sweaty with this sounds going on like I'm down in a swamp.
There's a skunk around my place. I keep smelling them. like almost every night. Yeah. Nasty fucker. He like releases some of his scent. Ugh. Like, you bastard. It's not like a lot, but it's enough to like definitely smell it. It's like, you son of a bitch. Prancing around, squirting nasty perfumes all over. It kind of reminds me of 420, though, every time I smell it, though, bro.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm going to Chicago. Oh, shit. And I'm sorry, but I can't take you. No, I can't. I said that I'm going it's your to favorite. Chicago. And I'm sorry, but I can't take you. Fuck that, man. We have a strict no Lou Rawls policy on this show. Never.
He's just a broke-ass jig. That's why he couldn't take her.
Now here's Going to Funky Town by T-Bone Walker. Let's check that out. See what this shit's all about. Well, Yoski Broski, the time has waned and waxed while we were whining and...
Yeah, the 420's coming to an end, man.
Yeah.
But only here, you know, in other places it's an hour or so
that's
different.
That's true. Hey, and every day is 420 day, right? In spirit, brothers and sisters, so... Raise up
your... Oh, yeah, especially since we just figured out that you can smoke the stuff.
Yeah. How about that, man? No fucking
way. Yeah, I always thought it was, like, bad for you and stuff. But it turns out it's not.
Hey, now that we've recently discovered that, it's time to check it out. What's all the hype about? You know, I was always a believer in that fucking reefer madness. I didn't want to go crazy and shit.
Yeah, just say no, right?
Fucking A, man. Lived on the straight and narrow and the fucking up and up.
Dude, I wore my Dare shirt until I was like 40, 45.
I know. Fucking that big, it was stretched over your fucking gut and everything. It was fucking horrendous, but you were such a... you were such a believer in the message that you couldn't let it go.
Every time I bend over, my butt crack would show halfway on
horrible.
My back.
Yeah, it was horrible. It was very, very offensive and shit. But like I said, you know,
I need to tie my shoelaces
again on purpose and shit. Creep. But yeah, but you were such a believer in that message that, you know, I knew it was going to be tough to let all this that gear go, all that shit. All that swag.
I was just reading in New Jersey that cops can essentially get high when they're not at work because they legalized pot.
Oh, shit. You know,
as soon as they leave the station, they light up.
There's like spark in it. They're still in their uniform, but they're in their own car. They're like, fuck you. It's like, motherfucker, you're still representing shit. What the fuck is this? People go, what the
on the way home, they see a crime and they just can't help themselves.
Yeah,
they gotta save the day, but they're stoned out of their minds.
And they handle it really smooth and well and shit, no problem.
They're like, "Excuse me, sir, are you robbing that liquor store?"
He's like,
"You shouldn't do that. You get in a lot of trouble."
He's like, "Hey, man, why do you want to do this shit? Come on, dude." Be cool, man. Fuck that shit.
Like, take a hit of this, bro.
He's like, are you fucking stoned, officer? Yeah, so what? You're harshing my mellow. Harshing my mellow. Ass.
That's like some California surfer talk shit.
Bro.
You're harshing my mellow, man. That's like something from a, what do you call it? The Lebowski. I could see him saying it in The Big Lebowski.
Like, hey, man.
He's like, hey, you're harsh in my mellow. Man.
Trying to get another.
Maybe it is from The Big Lebowski. Who knows?
Trying to get another fucking White Russian and shit. Gross.
A white mushroom?
In his ass.
Yeah. They bite his white mushroom. He's like, you're harsh in my mellow.
Very much so.
Like chopping it with your molars. Well, hey, bro, this is starting to kind of carry on and lag, you know?
Yeah, bro, is it starting to get too sleepy and shit? Hour 17, bro, that's about it, man. Alright. Well, everyone, we would like to say thank you for spending a little bit of time with us in celebration of the 420 event, bros and bro-esses. I've gotta say, I'm on my way. And in light of those events, it must be said that you will obey. Or you will rue the day you decided to betray. Become the past. It's in your face, like it's in your ass. It's all very straightforward.
On the airwaves.
And don't question me, or I'll punish you.
Hear that? Voted number one on the airwaves.
Number one on the airwaves and interwebs and all places where people like
international, things, worldwide.
On all the places where people like things of substance and quality. That's where you'll find us.
Every platform known to the human.
With our capes.
Number
on.
One.
Yep. There will be silhouetted, you know, backlit and silhouetted by the moon on the tops of the buildings with our capes on, ready. For any time there's a transgression shall be thwarted by our fucking
with our microphones in hand.
Superhero efforts, mics in hand, capes on, rocking it, saving it, jib jocking it, crim crocking it. Don't be rocking it, blocking it. Don't be knocking it.
Cock blocking it.
Yeah, don't. Oh yeah, nice. Don't be knocking it or cock blocking it. Take stock in it. Fucking, that's good. Anyway, thanks for hanging out with us. And however you 420, just 420 it up and 420 in a kind way, brother or sister, to each other or another or your mother.
Yeah, don't forget the hashtag, bro. Hashtag 420, man.
Hashtag 420, man. .com/ fucking
butthole
ranger 69, dude.
Rump ranger
69.
Yep, hashtag rump ranger 69.
It's a 69, but instead of turning towards each other, they're actually like back to back.
Was it actually like a 76 or was it a 66?
What's that?
Or The Rump Ranger.
Oh, 66, I think.
Phillips 69, bro, 420.
Phillips 69. Reverse 69.
Phillips 420.
Yeah, Phillips 420, brother. Bro. All right, everybody. Well, we will catch you later, and until then, just keep on 420ing, bro, dude 69, and stuff. Peace. Be with you. Always.